Navy football loses leader Zach Abey to injury as UCF earns its first 6-0 start. Central Florida coach Scott Frost, a former option quarterback at Nebraska, spent the week before Saturday's game against Navy playing his college position with the Scouts team to give his Knights the best possible preparation against the Midshipmen's option offense and their sturdy quarterback, Zach Abey. But Abey, Navy's leading rusher, was knocked out of the game after taking a hit to the head in the third quarter. In the end, number 20 UCF only needed to stave off backup quarterback Garret Lewis, who was appearing in a college game for only the second time. The Knights did so in a 31-21 victory before 35,277 at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium to notch the first 6-0 start in program history while sending the Midshipmen to their second defeat in a row. In addition to the loss of Abey, their leading rusher, the Midshipmen, 5'2", 3'2" American Athletic Conference, were missing senior fullback Chris High, the team's number 3 rusher who sat out the game with an undisclosed injury. Still, Navy was within 24-21 of the nation's top scoring offense and held the game's momentum early in the fourth quarter after Micah Thomas's interception. But Darryl Bonner lost a fumble on the ensuing drive and the Knights, 6-0, 4-0 AAC, sealed the win on the next series with a 7-play, 54-yard scoring drive. Otis Anderson provided the final margin when sliced through a loose Navy defense for a 10-yard touchdown run with 3:30 remaining. Quarterback Mackenzie Milton led UCF's balanced attack, which gained 247 rushing yards and 236 through the air. Milton completed 15 of 23 pass attempts for 233 yards and one touchdown to balance his interception. Frost has options as UCF's coach. Is leaving for Nebraska one of them? Navy had 419 yards including 248 rushing yards, nearly 150 below its nation-leading average coming into the game. Garrett completed 3 of 9 pass attempts for 56 yards and interception in relief, to go with 11 carries for 39 yards. Abey extended his program record streak of 100-yard rushing games to 8 before he was forced out. He finished with 25 carries for a game-high 126 yards and a touchdown and completed 2 of 4 passes for 115 yards, a touchdown and an interception. The junior went down with just less than 10 minutes left in the third quarter after taking what looked like helmet-to-helmet contact on Navy's second drive of the period. He looked shaken walking off the field as Lewis, a junior who appeared for one play in a loss at Memphis last week, ran on. Lewis had Navy clicking for a period against a tough UCF defense. Early in the fourth quarter he handed off to Anthony Gargiulo, a third-string fullback, for a 7-yard touchdown to cap a 10-play, 75-yard drive that included a 30-yard completion from Lewis to Bonner. The Midshipmen were within 24-21. Navy labored to get its offense going from the start against an imposing UCF defensive line that had been schooled by Frost. They were well prepared, and held the Midshipmen to 35 yards of offense and one first down on their first three drives while Knights quarterback Mackenzie Milton racked up 145 yards of offense on 22 plays. Milton gave UCF an early lead with a 10-play, 64-yard touchdown drive in the opening series capped with a 6-yard dart to a wide-open Trequan Smith in the end zone. They added another touchdown with just 3 minutes to go before halftime on a 5-play, 35-yard drive that ended with a 15-yard run from the speedy sophomore running back Adrian Killens. Navy's only score of the first half came on a 6-yard run from Abey. The only thing that kept the Midshipmen within reach, trailing 14-7, at intermission was one critical series from Navy's defense. They pinned the Knights on the 4-yard line to keep UCF from going up 14-0, and 5 UCF penalties for a loss of 35 yards. More college football. Complete college football scoreboard for Week 8. In loss to Badgers, Terps remain unable to match Big Ten's best on defense. 4 years after a national title, their heckling Jimbo Fisher at